Welcome to Refresher One, Part One of Refresher One. You must have completed your Level One or the initial introductory workshop. In that, Rajneeshji had put forward this aspiration that has been articulated in the National Education Policy 2020. It talks about education being fundamental for achieving our full human potential as a human being, an equitable and just society, and promoting national development. And for that, value education is something which is at the core of it. It has to be done. So now there is no question that we have to have value education or value-based education or not. It is something which has been articulated so well in the new policy. It has given the opportunity to do that. What that means, that has also been discussed, is that the development of a humane world vision is at the core of education, which can be called holistic and human. On the basis of this human world vision, the values can be identified, can be recognized. And with these two, the skills for living in accordance with human conduct, they can be developed. So for these three, the work that is going on at AICTE are these three things. Number one is universal human values for the development of a holistic and humane world vision. UHV is universal. Whatever is being discussed is the same for every human being in every place at all time. It is rational. It is something that is amenable to human reasoning. It can be verified. It can be verified on the basis of your natural acceptance, and it can also be verified in living. And it leads to harmony. Whatever is discussed leads to harmony. And what we have discussed in the initial introductory workshop is that this whole existence is something that is in harmony. It is a coexistence and not a struggle, not a chaos. So whatever human being is doing also would ultimately lead to that coexistence, to that harmony. And I am sure that you would have gone through the material that was shared after the workshop also and done your self-exploration on this and found, you know, your conclusions we would like to hear as we go along. Every day we are going to have some sessions in which your conclusions, your thoughts, your exploration you can share. So the part one of this human education is developing this overall view, and that can be facilitated through universal human values. It can be augmented with case studies of human thought. And a very good example of this is the Indian knowledge system. In India, it has been recognized in many centuries ago that human being is not just satisfied with physical facility alone. There is something more that is required. A whole culture is there of a family, of a big family, as a big family. And it has been developed over thousands and thousands of years. So case studies from the Indian knowledge system is the second part to give, you know, those kind of examples that will build further the confidence. And the third thing is value-guided skills. They have to be nature-friendly and human-friendly. And today, if we see all these three things are slowly being added into education, and it is certainly going to help in developing the kind of people that are required to work on this kind of society that we dream about, that we would like to have, that we would like to leave for our children. So this kind of holistic human value-based education would be required for preparing the kind of people that are required. With that kind of a society, which is equitable and just, national development will be a natural consequence. And the nation will be in harmony within, but also it will be in harmony with other nations. It would help to develop the similar harmony in other nations. AICTE has been working on this from 2017 at least. Before also it must have been working on it, but we are definitely aware of it from 2017 onwards with specific programs. It is very important to take the ideas and put it in such a way that it can reach the ground. And under the leadership of Sahasrabuddhaji, this has been a very important part of their effort since 2017. So there is a mandatory student induction program and a mandatory course on universal human values to develop this holistic worldview. So they are talking about not only value education, that is including a one or two subjects, one or two courses in the education, but they are also talking about going from value education to value-based education, where the entire education is value-based. And ultimately value-based living, that is the dream, that is the aspiration, I would say, not dream. Dream is, you know, without that much of responsibility, but this is something which AICT is taking great amount of responsibility for. So these programs are being conducted through AICTE. One is the introductory UHV FTP. It used to be in the 3-day face-to-face format, and now it is in the 5-day online format. Following this, to prepare teachers for teaching UHV 1 in an effective manner, is part one of the refresher, refresher one, part one. And at least we would like to have one faculty member from every department of every college to be prepared for teaching UHV 1. Following that will be part two of refresher one, for helping the faculty who are familiar with UHV 1 to also teach UHV 2. And that ratio is 1:120. So one teacher from every department for every 120 freshly joined students in that department. So it is not a matter of one department trying to share values, but every department, every discipline having you know, that kind of set of teachers. It'll be followed with refresher two, which is again 8-day face-to-face, and we might have to do it in an online format also, depending on the kind of situation that we go through. But right now it is planned as 8-day face-to-face to prepare faculty for teaching UHV 2 in a more, you know, deeper manner, and to do the faculty development programs. And then there are further courses that are there. So once again, let me welcome you to Refresher 1 FDP, part one of it. In the introductory workshop, you got that overview of living in harmony, of developing your thoughts around harmony in the human being, in the family, society, nature, and existence. And I'm sure that you would have worked on it. This workshop is about preparing you for teaching UHV 1. We will cover more details about harmony at all these levels. And the important point is that I'm sure that you would have come to conclude that for fulfilling your basic aspirations, it is essential to develop right understanding. And that right understanding is at the core of the problems also. Lack of right understanding is at the core of the problems also. So for example, for addressing a problem like anger, it is important to understand human being. It is important to understand the self and the feeling of trust in the self. That is essential. If we have done that, then these problems like anger will also be addressed. So if you look at the broad objectives of SIP, which I'm sure that you would have gone through in the preparation for this workshop, the third point is exposure to a holistic vision of life, developing awareness, sensitivity, and understanding of self, of the family, society, nation, nature, all that. So developing a holistic and humane world vision is one of the objectives, or starting that. It has three parts, again, focused on each of the three things that we talked about a little bit earlier. And there are specific modules for universal human values, is one module. On the Indian knowledge system, along with local, regional, national, international examples, which are focused on well-being of all, there are these six modules. And about getting introduced to the skill part, there are two modules. And we hope that they will be nature friendly and human friendly, and the practice of these kind of skills that will be there in the student induction program, and that universities will take note and make these programs more and more nature friendly and human friendly skills. I'm sure you can, you know, go through more details which have been shared earlier. From the UHV1 module, these five things are expected. And from this refresher one, if you are able to appreciate this, then you will be able to share it with the students in an authentic manner. It will not just be a transfer of information, but it will rather be a sharing of values. So the first thing is that I have an innate basic aspiration as a human being. You have to ask yourself whether that is true for you or not. To fulfill that aspiration, I need to understand. I need to understand whatever I'm related to. I need to understand that. So this is point number one. Point number two is that there are some problems in my life. I want to get rid of them. And I want to get rid of them forever, not just for the time being. I don't want to sweep them under the carpet. I don't want to just avoid them, but I want to get rid of these problems. And if we are able to see that to resolve my problems also, I need to understand something. Some reality is missing from my understanding, or the understanding of some reality is missing. That is why these problems are still there. If I understand that aspect of reality, then these problems will go away. So for example, in the previous slide, I was talking about anger. Nobody wants that anger. I don't know if you want it or not, but my view is that at least I don't want that. But it persists because my understanding of trust is not complete. If I understand trust, then this anger will go away. So that is the second point, that to deal with the problems, I need to understand some reality. The third point is that there is a definite reality to be understood. It is not some arbitrary thing. It is not unlimited. It is something definite to be understood. Fourth thing is, I have a real need to understand, which of course in the first two points also has been covered. But I have a real need to understand. I can understand. This confidence that I can understand, I have the capability to understand, is very important. We have been telling our children many times that you can't understand. You know, you just mug it up, just remember it. But now we have to see that we can understand, the child can understand. And we can also see that I feel happy when I understand, and I feel unhappy when I'm confused. So that is the fourth point, that I can understand. The fifth point is that I'm looking forward to understanding things. And UHV2 is a course through which I can, you know, explore. There are some proposals about the reality that are worth to understand. So I'm looking forward to that. So if we are able to do these five things for ourselves first, and then share it with the students through UHV1 module of SIP, it would be, you know, something which would be very helpful. And one very important thing is that we had shared a whole lot of homework with you. And after this, also between this one and refresher one part two, we will share some homework with you. It is very important that you do the homework. So at this point, I would like to, you know, once again, place the homework that was already provided to you as a part of the registration for this workshop. And I hope that you have done your homework, downloaded all the material, gone through the video recordings, read the course handouts, and come up with the deeper questions. We are not going to discuss a whole lot of your very fundamental, basic kind of questions. So if you have done your preparation, this workshop is going to be useful for you. And it is then going to be useful for the students after that, you know, through your preparation. After all, you are having an impact on hundreds of lives every year, hundreds of families every year. So you are reaching out to thousands and thousands of people every year, each one of you. So if you have done your homework, it would be very helpful. And with that, I'd like to wish you all the best. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Rajiv sir, for letting all our participants know about what the whole refresher part one intends to make it possible for them in their own process of self-development. Rajneesh sir, would like to interact with our participants.
Thank you, Vanchana ji. Namaskar. I'm really happy that today in this refresher one, we are having 686 participants who have joined. I don't remember. I think this is the highest number which we have in any refresher one earlier. Rajul ji can confirm me. Because earlier what I remember is it used to be 200, 300 or 400 kind of thing. Rajul ji, is it correct?
Yes, that is correct.
We all know that this refresher workshop is altogether different from our introductory workshop. In introductory workshop, generally the participants have been asked by the college management, by principal, by head of the department, that you have to participate in this workshop, you are nominated for this workshop. And then because of our college orders, we participate in that workshop. But this refresher workshop is altogether a voluntary participation. So I'm sure that none of the participants out of these 686 have joined this workshop because of any compulsion. So I'll request number one, if any one of you has joined it out of any compulsion because of some pressure from principal or head of department, so just talk to the organizers individually, personally, and I'll request Rajulji and other resource persons that we should allow them to leave the workshop, because this workshop is totally a very serious affair. A large amount of hard work is being put in by various resource persons. Here we need deeper discussion in every session. So that is possible only if we are all participating through our own aspiration as a voluntary, on a voluntary basis, because we need to go deeper into the questions of our own life. We need to go deeper for the interest of our own students. So that is the first step in this workshop. That's why Rajulji has talked to you about the pre-workshop homework. So that workshop, if that homework is not complete, then you will not be able to participate in the discussions with that seriousness, and with that kind of deeper discussions will not be possible. Number two is, we have to be very conscious about the purpose of our participation. The ultimate purpose is our own aspiration for having to be in continuous happiness and continuous prosperity, which when we go deeper into understanding, which is possible only when we are always aware of and conscious of the well-being of all. So now when we start from today's condition, our present status, our present conditioning and all other things, wherever we are, and we aspire for that aspiration, which is also our own self-acceptance, which is not being imposed from outside, then there are various steps in our own journey. And when we go from our stage one, our current stage, to the next stage, we have so many questions in our mind. And those questions must be answered properly within ourselves. And where Rajulji has used the word that we need to get rid of those questions, those problems, those obstacles. It is not that we just ignore it, okay, put it under the carpet and let us move ahead. That will not help us. We can't move ahead. We can move ahead only when we have answered all the questions which are coming in our own mind. So this is an opportunity where we can discuss things within the session, outside the session, in the whole group, in the smaller group, even on individual basis. We would like to have your feedback even as text messages or your audio messages. So now we are capable of having large number of volunteers, those who can discuss with you on one-to-one basis also. And that discussion can go on during these 5 days and even beyond these 5 days. So that is the way with which we conduct these workshops. These workshops are not just a five-day program. It is starting of a longer journey. It's just a start of longer journey. And another difference between introductory workshop and this refresher one workshop is maybe that the certificate of introductory workshop is important for your college, for your department, for telling your seniors in the management that, okay, look, I have participated in this UHV workshop and now I can be a mentor in this UHV, the first year SIP program. Of course, you will get a certificate of refresher one also, you will get a certificate for next workshop of refresher 2. But now it is not that important for your journey ahead, because now you are aspiring much more than that certificate. Now it is not because of certificate that you will be able to teach UHV course in your college, but it is because of your own confidence, because of your own commitment to the cause, that you will be able to teach your students, you will be able to interact your students, even if you have not been assigned the course of UHV to teach with first year students or second year students. But because of your own commitment, you will be interacting with your students in the same way, whether you are teaching them physics or mechanical engineering or electrical engineering. Now your relationship with the students, your outlook towards the students, that is to be changed. That is the purpose of this Refresher 1 course. So I'm really thankful that I'm talking to you in this first session, and I'll try to be with you in the last session also. And we will be taking this whole process to the students, to the next generation, so that the kind of, very rightly Rajuji said, that it is not just the dream, but it is the aspiration. The aspiration comes with responsibility, comes with commitment, comes with courage. So that's how we all will move ahead collectively. Thank you. Thank you very much.